In this section, let us see about external characteristics. Basically, in a motor, what is meant by external characteristic, and a generator also, let me tell you what is meant by external characteristic. External characteristic means that from consumer point of view, okay, for example, one generator is there. Okay, generator output is going to be, generator is supposed to give voltage. Okay, depending upon the load connected, currents will go. So terminal voltage, load current characteristics are going to be external characteristic for a generator. Okay, we have seen these external characteristics in our synchronous machines already. Okay, and let us think of what is meant by for motor. Okay, for motor, what is the output required? Motor will rotate the load. Okay, so if you keep on increase the load, okay, for example, for the motor, if you connect the brake drum, and for the brake drum, if you connect the belt, and if you keep on tighten the belt, so output torque requirement you are going to change. Okay, so if I keep on increase the torque requirement, what will be the speed? Okay, so external to the motor, from consumer point of view, what consumer see, if I want to rotate one particular load, or if I want to have one particular torque requirement, at what speed motor will rotate, that is going to be my consumer point of view. Internally, what is happening, whether armature reaction is there or not, or internally how much is the induced voltage and all, it doesn't matter. For a motor, output is going to be torque speed characteristics. Okay, now in induction motor, what is meant by speed? Speed can be converted into slip. Okay, so external characteristics for induction motor is nothing but torque speed characteristics or torque slip characteristics. We are going to derive those torque slip characteristics now from circuit diagram. Okay, so as I told you in my previous session also, circuit diagram is not a small topic of induction machine, but it is the heart of induction machine. Okay, so see here, we know that our model is going to be, I can consider this as rotor induced voltage ER, S times E2, or directly I can consider it as E2, because divided by S, divided by S, divided by S. Okay, so this is going to be variable R2 by S, and this is going to be X2. Okay, so for this we have drawn circle. Okay, for example, just we considered if resistance is 0, R2 by S is 0, what will happen? If R2 by S is infinite, what will happen? For example, if I think of, this is going to be simple network theory, locus diagrams only. We are not doing such a great things in machines here. Okay, so simple from network theory point of view, network theory, locus diagrams point of view, if I try to draw the circle, when R2 by S is 0, my I2 is going to be maximum, because impedance only this will be there, this is going to be 0. Under that conditions, I2 lag behind E2 by 90 degrees. Okay, and if I keep on increase the resistance value, circle is going to be this. Okay, so what will happen if I keep on increase resistance, and if resistance value R2 by S is infinite, under that conditions I2 magnitude will be 0, because impedance is going to be infinite. If I2 is 0, resistance is infinite, means that the angle between E2 and I2 is going to be 0 unity power factor. Okay, so this is going to be I2. This is going to be I2. When this I2 will be, when R2 by S is 0 or S tending to infinite. And here S equal to 0. Okay. And we know one more thing. Okay. What is that? Means depending upon the magnitude of current, torque will not be produced. But torque will be produced with component of current in line with rotor induced voltage. For example, S tending to infinite. Okay. At S tending to infinite, how much is the torque developed? E2. I2 cos of this is going to be 0. For example, if I think of here, I2. If I2 is here, means E2, I2 component in line with induced voltage is going to be torque developed. Okay. So one thing I have to tell you here. Okay. Why circle diagram is significant only in induction motor? Okay. In induction motor, circle diagram is significant because, for example, if I2 is here, okay, power factor should be this much only. For example, if I2 is here, power factor is going to be this much only. Okay, so slip is the independent variable. So with respect to slip, I2 and rotor power factor is going to be constant. So I2 and theta 2 are interdependent in each other. Combinedly, it is going to be slip only. So in induction motor, slip is the only independent variable. Okay, in transformer I2 and theta 2, two are independent variables, but in induction motor, slip is the only independent variable. Depending upon the slip, I2 and theta 2 are dependent variables. Okay, so I2 and theta 2 are interdependent in each other by the circle diagram only. Okay, so for example, if I want to have I2 like this, it's not possible. If I want to have I2 like this, it's not possible. So I2 and theta 2 should be in this particular circle only. So circle diagram is significant. Okay. Anyway, coming to the point, when you are going to get maximum torque is going to be here. This is going to be maximum torque condition. Okay. So at maximum torque, how much is the angle between this and this is going to be 45 degrees. Okay, so basically this is E2, this is I2. Okay, so I2 lag behind E2 by tan inverse of X by R. So what is happening here at maximum torque, what is X by R? X2 divided by R2 by slip at which maximum torque occurs. Okay, is going to be, X by R is going to be tan of 45. Okay, so tan 45 is going to be 1. Okay, that means that slip at which maximum torque occurs. Okay, just R2 by SMT equal to X2, SMT equal to R2 by X2. Okay, even after our mathematical calculations also, we are going to get the same. Okay, now depending upon where slip at which maximum torque occurs, let us divide the rotor characteristics into 3. Okay, but here let me tell you one thing. See here, how much is the length of this is going to be whenever R2 by S is 0 means that when S tends into infinite, how much is the current? I2 is going to be E2 by X2. So this length is going to be E2 by X2, the same point I discussed in our previous session also. So diameter of the circle is depending upon E2 by X2. Or the, what is the radius is going to be E2 by 2X2. Okay. So my maximum torque is directly depends upon E2 by 2X2. Radius of the circle is going to be E2 by 2X2. This is going to be radius. Okay. Or I can say that TEM is inversely proportional to rotor leakage reactors. Okay, so if rotor leakage reactor is inversely proportional, means that, as I told in our previous session also, X2 is not a term to play with. Okay, being a designer, always X2 they will try to design to be the least possible value, such that means my magnitude of maximum torque will be maximum possible. Okay, now coming to the point, what about rotor resistance? Rotor resistance, it can be variable. Okay, for example, if you think of squirrel cage rotor, in the sense, these are all are going to be slot coil sets, and those slot coil set at the end ring will be there. Here also end ring will be there. This is going to be squirrel cage rotor. Okay, in squirrel cage rotor, for example, my rotor resistance, I can keep my squirrel cage winding in this just bars. Okay, that particular bars, I may use copper, I may use bronze, I may use nichrome. Okay, so resistance, rotor resistance can be variable. Okay, but rotor reactance, no, from designer point of view, X2 is not supposed to be played with. Okay, now let us think of E2. I2 circle is this. Okay, so this is going to be slip at which maximum torque occurs. Okay, so at 45 degrees, slip at which maximum torque occurs. And this S, here S is tending to infinite, and this S equal to 0. Getting my point, right? Now, for example, see here, means in transformer, we have seen that X by R ratio should be more than 2. Okay, actually X by R ratio of transformer should vary between 2 to 6. Okay, forget about it. At least X by R ratio should be more than 1. Okay, so if X by R ratio is more than 1, slip at which maximum torque occurs should be 1 by more than 1. Okay, so slip at which maximum torque occurs should be less than 1. Okay, so for example, if I use copper bars, okay, so if I use copper bars, for example, this is going to be copper bars. Okay, so if I use copper bars, what will happen? Slip at which maximum torque occurs, because R2 is going to be less, X2 is going to be more. So slip at which maximum torque occurs should be less than 1. Now see here, this is going to be S equal to 0. Slip at which maximum torque occurs should be more than, sorry, less than 1. So 1 should be here. S equal to 1 should be here, because as induction motor, my slip will vary from 1 to 0 only maximum. Okay, so if I use copper bars, okay, R2 by X2 is less than 1, means that slip at which maximum torque occurs will be less than 1. So means that slip at which maximum torque occurs should be less than 1, 0, less than 1, 1. Okay, for example, if I use maybe bronze, in the sense, if I increase my rotor resistance such that, means rotor resistance exactly equal to rotor standstill leakage reactance. Okay, so when rotor resistance equal to rotor standstill leakage reactance, how much will be SMT? Is going to be 1. Okay, for example, I used bronze wire. Okay, such that, means R2 equal to X2. Okay, if I think of R2 equal to X2, slip at which maximum torque occurs will be 1. So if I use bronze conductors in the rotor, this is the situation. Okay, if I use copper bars, this is the situation. Okay, now let me think of maybe nichrome. Okay, means very high resistance. So if I use high resistance such that if R2 is more than X2, under that condition, slip at which maximum torque occurs should be more than 1. Okay, so slip at which maximum torque occurs is more than 1, this will become more than 1, 0, more than 1, in the sense 1 should be here. Okay, so let me think of, this is going to be S equal to 1. If I use nichrome, in the sense R2 is greater than X2, and here bronze, if I use, S equal to 1 will come here, R2 equal to X2. Copper bars, in the sense, S equal to 1 will come here, at this time R2 less than X2. Okay, so logic is very simple. What is that? Magnitude of maximum torque. So magnitude of maximum torque, is it depend upon rotor resistance? No. But it is inversely proportional to rotor leakage reactance. So the diameter of the circle will be decided by leakage reactance. But where my S equal to 1 operating point will be lying will be decided by rotor resistance. Okay, so if rotor resistance is less than rotor leakage reactance, so slip at which maximum torque occurs will be less than 1. So 0 less than 1, 1 will come here. Okay, now when R2 equal to X2, rotor resistance is increased such that R2 equal to X2, slip at which maximum torque occurs will be here. Okay, actually this is altogether different rotor, copper bars used rotor, this is going to be bronze bars used rotor, this is going to be nichrome bars used rotor. Okay, now let us try to draw external characteristics, that is going to be torque speed characteristics or torque slip characteristics. Okay, so let us see, for example, okay, so this is going to be S equal to 1, maybe this is going to be S equal to 0, so slip is going to be in this direction. Okay, or I can say when slip equal to 1, when stator is at standstill, so from speed point of view, this is going to be 0 speed, this is going to be NS speed, this is going to be speed, rotor speed. Okay, now what is the magnitude of maximum torque will be decided by rotor leakage reactance. So magnitude of maximum torque is independent of rotor resistance. So for example, this is magnitude of maximum torque, this is going to be torque. Okay, so torque speed characteristics or torque slip characteristics are going to be external characteristics for a motor. Okay, now for this maximum torque, let us see, maybe blue. Okay, so try to observe closely, dear. For example, if you think of blue, what is starting torque? Actually, S equal to 1 is starting. In the sense, if I strongly hold the rotor, not to rotate, under that conditions, what will be the torque produced? So when S equal to 1 here, copper bars, what is the starting torque? Is going to be this much. Okay, so component of current in line with rotor induced voltage is going to be torque. Now after that, S equal to 1, I strongly wanted the rotor not to rotate. Now I release the rotor. If I release the rotor, means my S equal to 1, it will accelerate towards S equal to 0. So my starting torque will start from, starting torque is here, and after that my torque is going to be increased to maximum. And after that, decrease to 0. Okay, so in order to draw torque speed characteristics of an induction motor, we need not use like, you know, any equations and all, not required. Simple locus diagram of network theory is sufficient. So see here, for this blue only, forget about red and black. For this blue, what is the starting torque of this much? And after that, starting torque is increased to maximum, after that decreased to 0, because if I strongly hold the rotor not to rotate, okay, S equal to 1, if I release, it will be accelerated towards S equal to 0. And it will settle down nearer to S equal to 0. Okay, so if I think of blue, okay, S equal to 1 is going to be S equal to 1 in the sense starting torque is less. After that, starting torque is inline component of rotor induced voltage is increased to maximum, reduced to 0. So okay, so what is happening if I strongly hold the rotor not to rotate? My starting torque is going to be this much. My torque magnitude, y-axis, torque magnitude increased to maximum, reduced to 0. Okay, now let us think of red. If I think of red, okay, means if I use in the place of copper bars, if I use bronze bar such that R2 equal to X2, under that condition, slip at which maximum torque occurs will be 1. So if I strongly hold the rotor not to rotate, then how much is the torque maximum? And if I release it, so S equal to 1 is here. After that, S equal to 1 to 0. In this, the current will be like this. S equal to 1 to 0. My torque is going to be reduced to 0. So it is going to be, okay, it's going to be like that. Okay, such that starting torque is going to be maximum, inline component of rotor induced voltage, starting torque is going to be maximum, after that torque is getting reduced. Now let us think of black. Okay, so if I increase rotor resistance, then what will happen? Means R2 can be more than X2. If R2 is more than X2, under that condition, slip at which maximum torque occurs will be more than 1. So 0, 1, more than 1, fine. Okay, so if I strongly hold the rotor not to rotate, this is going to be starting torque is going to be this much. After that, it's going to be reduced to 0. So means if I want to have maximum torque, it should be more than S equal to 1 for this black. Okay, 0, 1, more than 1. So 0, 1, more than 1. Like this. Okay, so this is going to be when blue is going to be when R2 less than X2. And red is going to be when R2 equal to X2. And black is going to be when R2 more than X2. Okay. So in this way, like, you know, means depending upon the rotor resistance variation, we can have torque speed characteristics like that. Now let us think of starting performance, running performance. Basically, when our Tesla invented this induction motor, at starting there were few difficulties in the primitive induction motor. Okay, in the primitive induction motor, in the sense, they used copper. Okay, so what are the main disadvantages of induction motor? Because from now onwards, we are going to continuously keep an eye on that, we are going to continuously observe that. Okay, so what observation we have to do? If you think of copper, primitive induction motor, when it was designed by Tesla, so what is the starting currents? High. What is the starting power factors? Very less. Power factor angle is more, so power factor is going to be very less. And what is the starting torques? Were less. Okay, so starting torques were less. Okay, so there are three disadvantages in primitive induction motor. The point number one, high starting currents. Point number two, less starting power factor. Point number three, less starting torques. Okay, so what is meant by starting performance? Starting performance in the sense, starting torque, starting power factor, okay, and also starting magnitude of currents. Okay, so in order to have better starting conditions, okay, in order to have better starting conditions in the sense, torque should be more. If you think of bronze, starting torque is very high. What is starting power factor? E2 to I2 angle is reduced 45 degrees. Okay, so starting power factors are improved, starting torques are increased, compared to here, starting power factors are increased and starting torques are increased. Magnitude of current, length of phase are in that one, magnitude of current we know, okay? So magnitude of current reduced. So in order to have better starting performance in the sense here, in order to improve the starting torque, okay? In order to improve starting power factor, in order to reduce starting currents, definitely rotor resistance should be more. Okay, now let us think of running conditions. Running conditions. If you think of running conditions, what are the parameters we have to consider in running condition? In running condition, performance that has to be considered is efficiency. Okay, because means our machines are supposed to be working under running conditions, not starting. Okay, at starting, if you are going to, for example, if you switch on your fan, what you do? You are going to switch on your fan and go and sleep. Okay, so that fan is supposed to be continuously rotating in running conditions, maybe for 7-8 hours. Okay, but you don't play at your machine, at your motor, like start, stop, start, stop, start, stop. You won't do that. So, means starting conditions will be there. Once it go to running condition stable speed, like, you know, running conditions has to be analyzed. Now running conditions, in the sense my machine will be in the running conditions most of the time. Most of the time, starting conditions only for some time it will be there. Okay, so point here is very simple. Very simple. What are meant by running conditions? Efficiency. Efficiency in the sense rotor copper loss. Okay, and speed regulation. Speed regulation in the sense means from no load speed to full load speed, means with respect to rated speed. Rated speed. Actually, I got a question, I think yesterday, about what is no load speed, what is base speed, what is full load speed, what is rated speed. Okay, I will do a detailed video for that. Okay, anyway, point here is very simple. Point here is very simple. Means speed regulation, efficiency, rotor copper loss. Okay, and one more parameter is there you have to focus. Okay, so what is that one more parameter? That is rotor copper loss. Okay, you may think of rotor copper loss has to be included in efficiency. No, in that case, why should we think about rotor copper loss again? No, rotor copper loss will increase the rotor temperature rise. That rotor temperature rise will hit the bearings. Okay, so bearings, basically, except, like, you know, there are many types of bearings, but anyway, except bush bearing, remaining all bearings, because of the increase in temperature, so those bearings can get struck. Okay, so separately, rotor copper loss part is separate, because it will hit the rotor copper loss, will increase the rotor temperature, will hit the bearings. That is one thing. Efficiency is another thing from electrical power point of view. Okay, and third thing is speed regulation. Now, for example, my full load speed is this. Sorry, full load torque. This is going to be full load torque. Okay, so at no load, how much it will be the speed? At no load, almost synchronous speed for all these three. So at no load, when torque requirement is zero, slip is going to be zero almost. So it will almost rotate at synchronous speed. But if you think of here, from no load to full load, my speed will be reduced this much, from NS to this much. If you think of red, from NS to this much, it will reduce. Speed regulation is more. Okay, if you think of here, no load to full load, speed will be varying from here to here. Speed regulation is more. So in order to have better speed regulation, okay, in order to reduce rotor copper loss, rotor resistance should be less. Okay, in order to improve efficiency, in order to reduce the heat upon the, what do you say, bearings, like, you know, rotor resistance should be less. Okay, so it means these two are contradictory statements. So in order to have better starting conditions, okay, my rotor resistance should be more. In order to have better running conditions, rotor resistance should be less. For example, if rotor resistance is less, speed regulation is less, or speed variation from no load to full load is going to be less. So there are two contradictory statements. Starting resistance should be high, running resistance should be less. In squirrel cage rotor, if I have squirrel cage, we should do some compromisation between starting and running performances, and we have to run the show. Okay, but if it is, like, you know, phase wound rotor or slip ring rotor, in the sense how we developed stator, A phase, B phase, C phase, okay, and how we have distributed the winding, how we have short pitched the winding, so same stator we are going to design in the rotor also, and we are going to insulate the rotor. We'll bring those terminals through slip rings, through brushes, to the resistance box. So in slip ring rotor, at starting, we can, inject some external resistance into the rotor circuit, such that starting performance can be better. And in running conditions, those external resistance will be cut down. It means characteristic is going to be this. Getting my point, right? So in slipping rotor, cost will be more. Why? We have to redesign the rotor completely. Okay, but if cost is more, obviously if you pay more money, you will get, like, you know, better things and all. Anyway, like, you know, means if you design your rotor for separately winding, under that conditions both starting and running performances can be achieved. Okay, but if it is squirrel cage rotor, you cannot insert any external resistance into the rotor circuit in the squirrel cage. So what you have to do, either starting or running, compromisation should be done between starting and running performances.